Hello everyone, this will be the review of game In Between, and the key was provided by developer. This is one of the situations where I know that the game is praised and I can't agree with it, but I will try to tell you what I don't like and what was the part that people liked. This is a puzzle platformer with gravity, with very limited, at least so far, gameplay. You generally only fall into one direction, one of the four directions, and you can change, alter that fall a little bit. And the whole gameplay is based, at least so far, on trial and error, how to exactly position yourself and do one step after another to beat the level. The puzzles are quite intricate, but I just didn't like the gameplay, that constant repetition of failing and going inch after inch into levels. So I will try to show you levels. I have to tell you that I didn't go very far in the game. It has a couple of groups of levels and they are supposed to be different. And I got completely stuck in the first one. So I just didn't get, maybe not that I didn't get, I didn't like the gameplay. I know what I'm supposed to do, but I just can't perform it. So it's on the level of Hollow Knight platforming, even worse actually, because Hollow Knight has also other elements aside from just platforming. This is basically falling into spikes and dying constantly all the time until you eventually, after hundreds of attempts, make it. It's even weirder that there's actually an achievement for not dying even once, so I'm not able to tell you how the hell is it even possible, how people can do it, when maybe someone can do it. Some people maybe are able to speedrun the game. I am definitely not able to do it. So let's see what's there. Options. Yes, we have quite okay options. We can change music sound and voice, and is it up? Yes, it's completely muted, so it should be okay. Also works fine in this resolution, so I just changed it into window to be able to record it. So let's go to a couple of levels that I unlocked. Pressed enter. I don't know why, but nothing happened. Oh, it's doing something. It's trying to start reacting. So this is the end of level. Apparently there is 60 levels. I'm not sure how they count it. Here you have 12. Maybe even more. No, I think this is the intro. Then we clearly have 12 levels. And then there's probably outro. 12 times 6 would be 72. They say there is 60. Yes, there is less levels. Okay, this is the ending. So probably there is less levels. Maybe there's 60 total. This is very likely. So let's check how it starts. It starts quite okay. I'm only going to show you a couple of levels from the beginning, right? So they teach you the mechanics. You can move around. I don't think you can jump. You can look up, apparently. That's cool. But generally, you would only move left and right, because most of the time you will be only falling. And as you can see, you can alter the fall. So this is what you can do, at least in this section of the game, in this beginning section of the game. I'm not sure if by telling that there are new mechanics, they mean that everything changes, or is it just new elements added and it's still the same. However, you will have probably big problems unlocking any further areas, because you will probably get stuck on this one, right? So once more, you can go to any wall, or you can go to the bottom, or you can go to the ceiling, and every time you change, you can't just change up and left. You can only change it once. So all you do in this game is position yourself, fall, or you can fall to the left, or you can fall to the right. Right? And of course, this is the same for every other direction. So if we are here, we can, let's say, fall like this, or we can fall like this, right? Or we can fall down like this. And this is the whole mechanic. So here it will be easy. We just do something like this. There we go. Right? Seems okay. However, it gets much more complicated. So I'm gonna go, yes, this is one of the levels I got stuck. So you have to learn it by, of course, trial and error. So let's say you go up. You are like, okay, so probably I have to go there. Right? So this section that you just learned is easy, right? You just do a couple of things, you make moves, everything is presented very well, you just keep going. Now you have no idea where to go, right? Because you don't see the left side, but you can still do this. You can go like that. Now here is the first problem. You have to fall and go left like this. Oh, actually I pressed the wrong button. Now that's the problem. You press the wrong button, you start over and the whole thing right from the start, right? Oh, now I tried to press right, but I forgot that when you're falling, you cannot change direction. So of course I died. So now I have to press it again, go down, left, down. This is basically a sequence. Left, down, right, down, left, up, go left. No, again, wrong button. I keep pressing the wrong button because one of the arrows is not what I think it is. I have to remember, right? Arrows are directions. Once more. So which direction I have to fall? I have to fall down, but I have to move left. Like this. Now I have to do what? Go up and quickly go left. Like this. Right? Now I can go down again, maybe go right, probably left. Now we have to make it go up, right? So we have to make it go up. Now I will probably fall. I think I have to just keep going. Actually, no, we can fall from here, right? Maybe we can, oh no, it was wrong. So probably I have to drop and go all the way right. Let's try it, if I can repeat the whole thing. And this is, guys, just one level. So the gaming time, if you're not speedrunning, will be long because you'll be repeating every single level many, many, many times until you learn it, right? So in terms of time, this might be okay. You know, 60 levels will take time to do, but they are this annoying, right? For me, this is just annoying. Because I can't really save, I have to always repeat the whole section, the whole sequence, pushing the same buttons, and eventually, how do I do it? I'm not even sure. If I go right, I'm probably dead. So I have to press down and run. Okay, like this. So now you unlock a section, and we actually beaten it. So that's the level, right? So this one. Last section was the very, very annoying part where you have to go exactly at the right moment, exactly being positioned where you should be. Like, if I'm here, I need to do this. Because if I do it an inch to the left or an inch to the right, it's all the way back, right? All the way to the beginning of the level. Let's see other levels. This is the one. So, what can I do here? I can't really do much. Of course, I could go right. But that's just that, I'm dead. I could go right and up, which does nothing. By the way, I can't really see the map, right? I can't really see the map to the right. So apparently, you have to go up and down at some moment, dropping to the right. But maybe from here, maybe from here, maybe from here, maybe from here. So let's see a couple of options. What if I dropped like this? Oh, I made it. Nice. So let's repeat it. What if I drop? I'm dead. All right. So what do we do? We go up. I'm trying. I'm dying somewhere. I'm dying in specific spots. Maybe you have to die, actually, to see the picture. Interesting that my deaths are actually unlocking pieces of the picture. Very weird. Okay, this worked. See, I have no idea when should I go from here, because all I can do is drop, right? I can only drop and drift to the right. I don't know when. Maybe that was a good idea. Maybe I should drop. Well, there's actually an option. See, I still know how I could do this part. Yeah. So I could drop there. Maybe I could go like this and quickly move, right? So just let it fall. Let's drop from here. So it's gonna move quick. It doesn't move quickly. When is it not close to me? I go right, I will probably die very quickly. I think we have either option from the how to call it, either from the bottom or from the top, I guess. What if I go left? The gravity would change. I'm not sure if those would move. Probably they wouldn't. I don't think they would move. So let's try to go from here. Maybe from here. No, of course not. And again, repetition, right? So you go there. Go there. And maybe go from here. No. Still don't know how to do it. I'm just getting stuck here all the time. Still don't know how to do this one, right? Just constant failing. What if I go from the further element? Yes, if I go from further, it works. What if I go from further here? No, it doesn't work. So here you can go from afar, kinda, but here no. Here you have to go from, maybe you have to go from afar as well. Like this, no. So maybe let's try one more thing. That was far, it was not far. You have to probably record it and keep trying until you know, or just use a wiki maybe. What if I instantly go? Okay, if I instantly go. So it's far, close, instant. And now I have no idea. Maybe instant. Well, one of the moves is wrong, right? So if I drop from there, let's go quickly. Okay, that was okay, but I failed. So okay, far. No. Kind of far, but actually go all the way. So far all the way. Close. That was instant, right? Instant. And now I was like here. I think I was here. Yeah, so made it barely. After learning the whole thing multiple times, made it. So I was stuck, now I'm not stuck. Still doesn't help. This one, I don't think I can do it. Maybe I did it. I don't think I did it. Why I don't do it? Ah, there is, I guess, a way to go past it. So, okay, I think I know what's going on. I have to do it in the last moment. Right, like this. But here I had no idea. I think it was like this. Then it was, yeah, it was like, yeah, I have no idea how to do it. I have to go right, probably let it fall, and we survived. Now we can go up, and we can go down, and like this. I made it this time. So it's better after you, probably after you train it's better. Let's see if I unlocked anything. No, one more level, right? So I was able to do it. I have to do one of those three and I probably won't be able to. But let's try it. Let's try to do it. Still have no idea how you do this one. Maybe you don't. Yeah, maybe you would go like this. I can fall. No, probably that's not the idea. Yeah, I still have no idea how we do it. I think we have to drop. Maybe. Probably not. What options do I have? I could go to the left. Right? Maybe it's just dropping there. Probably not. Maybe. Maybe, just maybe. How do you move it to the left? I don't know. Maybe it doesn't affect. Maybe you have to move it more. Like, don't go on the ground, but go move. How to call it? Go like this, right? And then go left. Drop. Go like this. Then probably you have to fall. Right, so first is the section where you have to keep going like this, and then up, and then move it like this, and up, and be prepared here. Drop on it somehow, probably not like this. Maybe it's too far, maybe like this. So now I can position myself, move it like here. That's probably too far. Now again, position myself closer, fall. No. Ah, it's annoying. Let's try it again. I'm trying. I think that's the idea. But the fact that you can't save is just killing me. Because, you know, I know it's gonna go bad. I know it's gonna be another, yes, another, of course. Ah, let's try another one. Just, I'm getting pissed here, but that was the whole time I played this game. Once more. Maybe this one. I won't be able to do any of those, I'm afraid. This is probably even worse. How does it work? You go up. Yeah, that's another one with this moving platform. Yeah, it doesn't work. How do I move it to the right? Probably all the way. Ah, I think I know. Same story. You move it. Now we can go there. But this one doesn't move. I have no idea. I could go to the left, probably. If I go to the right and drop, it doesn't help. How do I move it to the left? Probably I move it like this. Right, yes. I move it like this. Then I have to prepare the other one. Again, by drifting. Okay. I drift. I move it. In position, kinda. No save, of course. It should be going left. Alright. So I can now go up. Left. Left is what? That's left. Now we have to go there to the left all the way. I'm going move by move, right? And now, well, that's bad. I'm trying to understand how I'm going. I go down. I could go up like this and just fall there. Yes. So I'm going to show you one. Well, should I show you? Yeah, I can show you the graphics because this is the section in between, I guess. Am I moving? Yes, I'm moving. So you have this section between the puzzles when you see this sort of graphics. And then something happens. I'm going to go through it. Not sure what it is, actually, but yeah, I came through here. Maybe I have to move there. And maybe that's the idea. Maybe I have to move there. It's going to probably show me an animation or something. Yeah, it's going through an animation. And yeah, that's some darkness. Yeah, of course it's chasing me. Of course it is. No idea how I go. Okay, something happened. So I'm a kid and I can fight the darkness. So we have to chase it. Is that the case? Yes. Chase the darkness away. And we are big one again. We grow up. And is this the case? Probably. Yeah, that's the case. And I will show you one level of the next, probably, what is it? Jesus. Ah, okay, I get it. So, this is the new mechanic, right? So after going through the annoying section in the first part, now we have another annoying section. Oh my god, this is not the case. Yeah, there's all of those. How many do we need? Let's see how many do we need. I don't know. 9. So we don't have to do all. You can do 9 out of 12. So that's nice. Let's just do one. So you're supposed to escape from darkness somehow. I don't know how you do it. Oh, it's gonna move from both sides, probably. Not sure what's the idea here. And you have to be careful and just don't get in it, because they are gonna squeeze you. I mean, the mechanics are the same, because you constantly do this falling and altering your fall thing, gravity thing. Nothing else is here. I'm not sure why it's moving. Maybe the one that you look at is escaping. Okay. Yeah, this is again a piece where you have to learn. You have to learn what you're doing. No, it ate me. So maybe it's time-based. I don't know. I'm not sure really how it works. I'm going to leave you with this. So, let's go back maybe. Can I go back? Yeah. So, you have 60 levels like this. You have those sections where you don't exactly do the puzzle. You just see a little bit of the story. There is narration, there is music, there is sounds, but I'm not going to go into this. Those are just in between levels, actually in between big sections of levels. So you have to go like 12 levels or 10 levels or 9 levels and then see a part of the story and then move to another section with another mechanic. But it seems that the core mechanic is the same, the falling and altering your fall thing. I actually played it a bit longer because I got stuck so far. I just beaten those couple of levels now, but that was like 3 levels in 20 minutes. Before I play, how much did I play? Let's see if I can check it. No, it was more because I was getting also trading cards. Probably, I don't know, it's just going through the level. If you know what you're doing and you learn it, it's probably a speedrun. It must be very quickly, but the repetition can go into hours. Probably it was a couple of hours of trying. I tried it like in a few sessions and I was failing a lot. But yes, you can eventually learn how to do the level and beat it if you know exactly when to move and when to stop and what's the mechanic and is it time-based, is it not time-based. Time-based parts are, of course, awful for me. I hate them. I also don't like platforming in general. I like when games have platforming that makes sense with the rest of the game, like in Tomb Raider, like in Dark Souls, like in... even in Hollow Knight, but there was also very annoying platforming. Salt and Sanctuary was okay. So I don't hate it as a part of the game if it's not very annoying, but if it's designed to fail, if all you do is falling into spikes 100 times and then beating a level, I'm very, very annoyed. But this is just me. This is because I don't like the genre. So if you like challenging platforming, you will definitely find it here. I just personally find it very annoying and frustrating. Is it well done? Well, yes and no. The presentation is great. The way it's designed, for me, is very annoying. For instance, you cannot change the gravity when you're falling. If you fall up, you fall up. All you can do is alter left and right. So they have those arbitrary rules, and the whole game is based on one gimmick and tons of trial and error, and I personally don't accept it. But if you like it, if you think it's a good idea, if you want a hard game that you need to learn piece by piece and master every level, dying and repeating the same section, if that doesn't annoy you, then you probably will like it, because it's well presented and there is quite a lot of levels to beat. 60 levels with well, an idea for a level, right? Because each level has maybe even hidden secrets somewhere. I'm not exactly sure how you get them, but apparently you get pieces of the picture sometimes and you unlock some secrets. Aside from that, you will be doing just this repetition, right? So you will be learning one move, then going a bit further, then failing, then repeating another move. You could pretty much write this down or record it, like how you do a level. And as I was doing it before, it was like jump from the far, jump from the close, jump instantly, and then, I don't know, go right, up, left, move a little bit, and then there you go, right? The whole thing. If you know it, it seems easy. If you don't know it, it's many attempts and a lot of annoyance. So good presentation, and I'm not happy with the gameplay, with just how the gimmick is done. That all you do is you control a fall. And yes, it's somehow unique and interesting because you control the fall to any direction, any vector. So you control gravity, which isn't maybe completely unique, but it's rather rare. So some games have it, many games don't have it. This one is definitely about gravity. So that's okay, it's a nice topic. Problem is that you don't really do much in terms of controlling your character. All you do is position yourself and fall. And then you position yourself and fall again, maybe in different direction. Not all directions, of course, you can go to, because there are spikes. But multiple times it's gonna be fall, alter your fall, fall, alter your fall. And that's how it goes. That's what you do. And then there is, of course, new mechanics, but the core controls on the character seems to be the same, at least after first two sections, right? First section is clearly like that. Second section probably have to outrun the darkness, but again, all you do is you fall up and down between obstacles in a proper sequence. If you mess up the sequence, you die, you have to start over. There is no saving in the level. You have to repeat entire levels. So it is challenging for sure. It is well presented, but I don't buy the gameplay. I just personally don't buy it. However, someone might. So for me, this is 5 out of 10. It's average, above average presentation, and below average very annoying gameplay. But that's just my opinion. You might disagree with that. If you accept it, if you like it, then you might probably have a good time with the game. It's not that cheap. I think it's around $10. So for a puzzle with 60 levels, that's not entirely very cheap. So if you want to buy it, I would wait for sale. And I hope I was able to show you what it is, because I definitely can't beat every game, especially the game that is too hard for me or in the genre that I don't play and don't like. But I was at least trying to show you what it is, so I guess you will be able now to make a decision. Also, you might be able to find a guide on YouTube somewhere. If someone was speedrunning it or made all the levels, that might be helpful if you get stuck. Because probably you will get stuck, unless you're very good in those games. So that would be it from me. That was In Between. I give it 5 out of 10. And I will see you in another review. Hopefully the one that I will actually enjoy to play. See you next time.